Welcome back to Bill Bosporus. There we are on the ground at Amsterdam to Derry Airport with KLM-737. Look at that, beautiful on the ground. Let's look to the message. All right, we have to start on time, so we're gonna call the pushback. Request pushback. APU bleed is on, left and right packs, we're gonna turn that off. Anti-collision light. Park brake is set. Right, we're gonna turn on the fuel pumps, left and right. And the window heat, we turned that on. Passenger signs and okay, the seatbelt sign are okay.
All doors and hatches closed and all ground equipment is removed.
The parking brakes are set. You may lift.
Parking brakes set. Lifting the aircraft.
Departure will be from runway 36 left. And
push.
We will do...
Okay, clear it for push start. Please
this departure. 36 left, and then Berk to Zulu departure.
Please release parking brake.
And current fuel on board is 6,300.
Please release parking.
And this is
brake.
The first leg on the Workhorse 737 tour.
Please release parking.
Right, start
brake.
Engine number 2. Release parking brake.
Parking brakes are released.
Commencing pushback. You can start the engines in sequence.
It will start in the sequence.
Bean Media Creations, hey sir, how are you? Yes, I am fine and nice to see you. Bean Media, welcome aboard, welcome. We are starting engine number 2 and waiting for completely has been started up. That will be a great takeoff from Amsterdam. is Turkish. Right, starting up engine number one. Set.
Parking brake set.
Parking brake set. Lowering aircraft.
Ground, you may disconnect.
Okay, sir. Cleared to disconnect. Pin has been removed. See you at the side. Have a good flight.
Holding position, waiting for the visual. Thank you and goodbye.
Let's turn on the runway turn off lights, taxi lights, wing lights, wheel lights, and let's do the landing altitude. It should be on 23 feet, but we keep it on 50 feet, is okay. Engine start switches continuous. And generators left, generator 1 and 2, turned it on, and APU off. Hydraulic pumps on, left and right back auto, APU bleed off, and the probe heat, we turn that on. Right, flaps 5, position, going to 5, and trim settings 5.4. There it is. Auto brake, RTO, and actually we are ready for taxiing. Let's turn on the flight director. Traffic and altimeters set. QNH 1013. Right, let's go. Taxiing to runway 36 left. Release parking brake. And still on taxiway Alpha 1. And we go to Alpha 19. Charlie. Spoilers are working fine. Ground speed 17 and braking for a turn. We take the next to the right. Uh, Okay, and left we have another traffic. Right is free. Let's turn on the VNEV and the LNEV. Alright, here we're gonna make the turn to the left. We're gonna cross over runway 36 center. Via Charlie 3 taxiway. What's wrong with the taxiway? No traffic. Arslan Özcan, hoş geldiniz. Aleyküm selam. İyi uçuşlar demiş. Beautiful Delata Otofiç, welcome on board. We are close for the departure. Oh, there is a bumpy taxiway there. What's that? That's going easy. What's wrong, man? Look at that. Oh, nothing will be happen. It's fine, okay. Just continue taxiing. Alright, we are almost at holding point, runway 36 left, and we are gonna holding there at that point, and then we're gonna do the takeoff checklist. Let's do the hold here. I don't know what happened with the holding point. There is no holding point here. Okay. Let's do the checklist. Engine starters on continuous is set. Strop and steady. Left and right pecs. We're gonna turn that off. LNAV and VNAV is on. Let's do TARA. Charlie mode, we're gonna turn that on. Traffic at EHAM lining up. And take off runway 36 left. Send message and TCAS, we turn that on so all the traffic can see us. But there is still no AHAM tower, so we're gonna line up and we're gonna take off. Release parking brake. Landing lights, turn that on. Engine power, 40%. Lined up and takeoff power set. Eighty knots checked. V1 rotate. Positive rate, gear up. Autopilot. Past 1500 feet. Engines are okay. Flip one. Flip going to one. Flaps up. Let's climb further to flight level 380. Left and right back to auto. engine start switches off. And auto brake off. Flaps up and off, gear up and down, checked. Everything is okay. İlker Efe, teşekkürler. Sağ olun. Sizlere de iyi uçuşlar. Deleta Otofiç, wonderful, fantastic. Thank you very much, Deleta. Lovely takeoff from Amsterdam. Beautiful. Looking from the left wing. And we're gonna make the turn to the left very soon. And let's turn on the FPV, and the meters are on. AM 015, we're already there. Look at that climbing. So there we're gonna speeding up. Landing lights off, taxi lights off, wing lights, wheel lights off, making the great turn to the left. There are several traffic there, we can see, around Bergi. We're still climbing, flight level 140, climbing 32380. Temperature, total air temperature is right now 40 degrees. And when it is 10 degrees, we're gonna turn on the wing anti-ice and the engine anti-ice. All right, everything looks normal in this flight. We're gonna flying above the North Sea. Look at that, beautiful. There is Den Helder, Texel there. Beautiful place, North Holland. All right, temperature, total air temperature is 10 degrees. So switch that wing anti-ice and engine anti-ice. We don't need that on the climb and the cruise, only when we are descending, so that's not necessary. Turn off the seatbelt sign, off position. currently climbing to flight level 380. Let's go into the cockpit again. Still at flight level almost 260. We have to go to 12,000 feet to reach flight level 380. Let's go to the flight management computer on the climb. We need 62 miles for flight level 380 and reaching that point at 10:57 Zulu time. It's about 8 minutes. After Supur to Mimfa, Emlon, Lekro, Nalax, all at flight level 380. Next page, Remsi, flight level 380. And after Remsi, we go direct to Nelbo, descending to flight level 235. From there, we are going to start descending. Right, there we are on the cruise. Flight level 380 is exactly 11,576 meters. Let's say 11.5 kilometers from the ground. Top of descent, we have 209 nautical miles. It's about 11:26 Zulu time. It's about 1 hour and 27 minutes. No, that's too much. Let's look. It's about 27 minutes. If there is some ATC, IVAO network. Still nothing, no ATC. For the approach, we gonna approach arrival ILS 26. Let's check out the wind at EGAE Derry Airport. Wind is from 040 at 12 knots. Let's go, we're gonna make better a choice to the runway 08 is better. We have more than 10 kilometers few clouds at 3500, temperature 23 and dew point 16 degrees, QNH 1015. Okay, so we have to make a change for the landing. Let's do ILS 08 from AGT. Gonna execute that. All right, unit ref page. From there, we're gonna get the ILS frequency 108.30 and core setting 073. And we're gonna use flaps 40 with speed of 131 with the wind correction plus 5. So, should be around 136 or 135 at the landing. But first we're gonna put in the frequency 108.30. Let's do that on the boat side as always. That's the frequency, so keep it on standby. And for the course heading 073, you can put it there. That's the best choice we can do for the landing, runway 08, because of the wind. And as you can see, it was automatically filled in a VOR frequency. That's for the Oscar Tango Romeo VOR. It's probably this frequency, 113.90. Let's switch that to the active. Let's change that so it will disappear from the navigation display, as you can see. Alright, we have a total air temperature, minus 30. And let me look, the static air temperature is minus 55. Deviation of 1 degree. Great. There is the coastline of England, and I believe this point is Cleethorpes. This point, it's very close. And there is the Wither and Say this side. Then we go to Hull, South Cave, Goole, Selby, and so on. Over Wakefield and Bradford. top of descending. We have 160 nautical miles to go. Alright, we're almost reaching our top of descent, so we're gonna turn on the seatbelt sign. All passengers turning on their seatbelt sign, and we are gonna turn on the engine anti-ice. And for the runway, let me look. What's the runway length? Oh, it's 1.9 kilometers, so it's a very short runway. I believe we're gonna use auto brake 3 or maybe max. We can maybe use maximum brake. It's better. And we are gonna resetting the altitude, or the, let's do flight level 270. There it is, to an elbow. Alright, everything is filled in. Our ILS frequency 108.30, course setting 073, and flaps 40 with speed 130. Let's refill that. Go back to the leg. And we started with descending. What's going on there with that flickering on the display? What's wrong? Maybe something with the altitude. Elbow. It's really strange. I don't know what happened there, but anyway, it looks okay. And let me check the weather conditions at the arrival airport. Still the same matter. Wind from 040 at 12 knots. Visibility more than 10 kilometers, few clouds at 3,500, 23 degrees and 16 degrees dew point, QNH 1015. Let me sit there. And let me check out the airport information. Elevation was 23 feet above sea level. And let me show you where is that. There it is. So we can see the airport elevation 23, and runway guard lights positioned at holding points. Runway length is 6,460 feet, so that's 1,969 meters. So that is very short runway. So we're gonna use maximum brakes on the landing. Hopefully we can stop on the before reaching the end of the runway. Additional runway information, usable lengths, threshold and glide slope. Width is 45 meters, that's enough, no problem. PAPI at 3 degrees. Takeoff runway available. Let me do another check for the arrival. ILS 08. Eglinton. Let's do 3,500 in the meantime. Alright, we can see that the charts are available. Eglinton localizer 108.30, we did it. Final approach course 073, we also did that. And decision altitude is 262 and height is 241. Airport elevation 23. And on missed approach, we're going to climb straight ahead to 2500, then turn left to hold at 2500 or as directed. Transition level by ATC, transition altitude 3000. So we're going to set it on 3000 or QNH. Control required. ILS DME reads 0 at runway 08 threshold. Proceed established outside controlled airspace. MIM ALT to commence procedure from holding 2500. Single engine. Do not overfly chemical plant 2 to 3 miles west of airport below 1500. Procedure restricted to maximum 210 knots. There we go. From there you can see we're gonna make the approach. Direct arrival. AGNTB. AGNTB. Where is AGNTB? We're gonna descending to 2,500 feet before the glide slope capturing. Right, we checked it out and we seen everything and it's okay. We're gonna turn that off, the chart, so you can watch the approach. Still descending. I don't know why this is so flickering so much. What's happening? Drag required. Maybe for these 2 points, AGT and B has different altitudes. Let's clear this one. AGT 10 mile. Let's do this point. What is M pallet? Let's do erase. What's wrong with this, man? Execute that and drag required. Right, let's use the spoilers a little bit. Let's check if we can do an G we can do. There we should fly at 3,500. Direct arrival. Let's execute that. After that, we will go to Lunex. 3,500. There is no Lunex. Let's put it in Lunex. 3,500. Yep. Execute. Gives a standard, no worry. We're gonna do that transition out at 3,000. After Lunex, we're gonna go to. Let me check the approach chart again. Lunex, 3,500, and then we're gonna go directly to. What a strange approach is this. Lunex, after Lunex. For category A, B or C, D. Heading 235. Heading 235. Maximum 210 knots. Let's put in the speed. 210 knots. Let's use the spoilers. We are a little bit too high. Maybe we have to hold at Dungo. Let's go to Dungo. Next hold. Dungo. Gonna make a right turn, heading to 91 or 295 is okay. 1 minute turn, radial 115, execute that until we're reaching 3,500 feet. Dispatch unachievable. Drag required. No problem. Dungo and Lunex is maximum 210. So let's put it in. Execute. It's the same 210. Continue the flight route after Lunex to AGTNP. No, that's not correct one. Erase. Go to this one maybe. Mm, country. Let me check the altitude. Flight level 120 is okay. There's the hold. Below 10,000. Landing lights, runway lights, taxi lights, engine start switches to continuous, wing lights, wheel lights, turn that on, baby. And we're gonna turn off the engine anti-ice. It's 10 degrees exactly. Let's turn it off. Engine and the wing anti-ice. Descent checklist. Pressurization, landing altitude. We did that. Recall checked. Auto brake is max. Landing data VREF minimums is set. Approach briefing completed. Go to approach altimeters. Maybe flight level 080. Here we are at the northern of Ireland, to Derby. Speed 210 and flight level 060. We're still flying too high, so we're gonna rapidly descending. Doing GV 3500. right almost at flight level 035. Exit holding, execute, exit armed, spoilers down to 10th. Let me check out if you get a warning, an altitude warning. There is no warning, cause the altitude is safe enough. Oh, there it is, 2500 altimeter. Right, there we are going direct to Lunex, and after Lunex we're gonna proceed direct for the ILS approach 08. It's gonna be quite a short runway, so we're gonna using the maximum auto brake. Right, almost leaving Lunax, so we're gonna turn on the heading selector. Heading 262. We're gonna go a little bit further, so we can make an easily turn. Keep the speed on to 10. Still flying at the flight level 035. We are close for the last turn, for the final approach. Right, from here we can turn to right heading, let's do heading 345. Set MCP altitude to 1000. Descent to 2000. Let's do speed 165. Flap 1. Flaps 2.
Five hundred.
flap 5. Alright, there we go for the ILS approach. Press the approach button. Speed 165. 134 is landing speed. Right, QNH 1015, set and checked. Speed 134. Flaps 15. Gear down. Flaps 30. Flaps 40. Established on ILS, 2,000 feet. Landing checklist, auto brake, maximum, set, flaps 40, green light, checked, gear down, green light, checked, spoilers armed, green light, checked, advise cabin crew, landing lights are on, engine start switches continuous, and landing checklist completed. Speed brake armed, landing gear down, green light, flaps checked. Use autopilot A and B. Right, here we go. Landing.
1,000.
Salih Uluç selam demiş. Aleyküm selam Salih. Kusura bakma biraz Geç gördüm. Şu anda inişteyiz. Plot off.
I think you can do better.
Reverse. Than this. 60. Release the brakes. That was a great landing. With maximum brakes. Welcome at Dublin, temperature 17 degrees. Alright, turn off the terrain and flight directors, turn that off. Starting APU, turn off the landing lights and engine start switches off. Start switches off. That's okay. Doing a replay landing after we close down everything. Alright, taxiing back to the gate. Set to steady. Let's go a little bit on the right side. Keep the left wing safe. Yeah, that's safe. That's okay. Right, parking brake set, engines shut down, full pumps turn off, anti-collision light off, wing light off, wheel light off, runway turn off lights off, taxi lights off, we keep 3 minutes. Seatbelt signs off. Hydraulic pumps, turn that off. Prop heat off. Checked. Look at the temperature on behalf of the brakes we used. We used the maximum brake for the short runway. It was 1900 meters. Right, we're gonna wait 2 minutes and then we're gonna turn off. We go offline and then we're gonna looking for the instant replay how we did the landing. Hope you guys you enjoyed this flight. This was leg one from Amsterdam to Derby Airport. It was around 2 hours live streaming. Hope you guys you enjoyed this live stream, and I hope that we can see each other on the next flight on leg two. I don't know which flight it will be, at flight leg two. We will see that later. And don't forget to leave a thumbs up and a comment. I see you guys on the next flight. Have a nice day. Bye bye.
terrain. Too low terrain. Too low terrain. Too low terrain. Too low terrain. Too low terrain. Too low terrain. Too low terrain. Too low terrain. Too low terrain. Too low terrain. Too low terrain.
Yeah, we definitely touched down. Thank you.